Summer Brook Farm was a project that we wanted to involve a lot of young people with. It started with looking for a subject that we haven't used in a film before, and the Second World War as an era was very, very good. And there was also, me being a musician, I liked the idea of the music involved. So we decided to go for a Second World War storyline. Once we had a story, we put the story into script form. Then we had a look at characters, young people that could act for certain characters we were looking for, and also, for a change for me, working with adults. We always approach our casting with an audition where possible. We auditioned the young people from Peppercorns, and the adults, rather than audition, we just met and interviewed. Then we set about putting our cast together. The rehearsals, I felt, to me, were probably the best fun I've had in filming ever since I've been involved in films. The whole mixture of adults and young people was so informal and so friendly that I think it made it one of the best projects I've ever done for rehearsing. It was really great fun. We had worries about the production, initially controlling 40 or 50 children on a railway station, certainly trying to be accurate to Second World War costume and props. I feel this film will turn out great fun. I would hope it will be taken tongue-in-cheek, and I hope it will be, with its tinges of sadness, will still overall be regarded as a very happy ever-after film. I wanted to reflect something in this film that perhaps people in the Second World War were desperately looking for, a little bit of escapism. I'm not quite sure how other people will view the film, but people that had been around in the Second World War, I'm hoping they will feel a tinge of familiarity and nostalgia watching the attitude and the speech of the young people acting in it. And I would hope that the younger generations watching it will think, what a lovely era that must have been to live in amongst all the horror. I've been involved in many projects over the past 10 years, probably the past 6 years with filming, but I think Summer Brook Farm has to come out as my favourite. The sheer fun and the sheer enjoyment and enthusiasm of the cast, I'm going to remember for years to come. It was wonderful.
I heard about the Summer Brook Farm project from Steve when he announced it at Peppercorns, and I thought it sounded quite cool, so I put my name down. Well, he announced when there would be the auditions. We had to prepare a poem, and so I prepared one of the poems from a Roald Dahl book, and I read it to them at the audition. Some of it was difficult, but it was basically what I expected, so it was quite easy. Yes, I was surprised to get the part, because there was two of us who wanted to be Lily, and the other person was very good as well, so I didn't think that I would have a chance. When I got the part, I was quite worried because there was a lot of lines for Lily, and in the other films that I'd done, I hadn't had that many lines, and so I was quite worried about learning them. I found them quite hard because we had to get all the movements in as well as remembering our words. As it got closer to the filming, I got quite worried, so it was harder to concentrate on learning my lines. Filming for a whole week was quite tiring, because some nights we filmed quite late to do the night scenes. But for most of it, it was okay. I think it'll be quite good because we put a lot of time and effort into it. But I'm not sure that everyone will like it. I did enjoy making the film because I got on really well with all the crew and all the cast. And it was really good fun.
I got the part by going to the first audition. Getting through the first audition, went to the second. And then they asked me to play the part of Bill, and I'd done it pretty well, so that's why they gave me the part. Well, they gave us a script, and then we went to Steve's house to practice, and I learnt my lines at home and learnt my lines at Steve's, and the character suited me well because, like, kind of silly and a bit bossy, and we had to do the cow scene, which was the main scene for the boys. I had to pump the cow's tail, and it was easy to act without the real cow, but with real cow, you don't know where he's going to move, when you know he's going to headbutt you or not. Yeah, it was really fun. The best bit was the cow scene, I would say, because that's just big laugh and everyone was just basically kicking their head off. The worst bit was waiting for the cow scene. Everyone was basically great because we were all supporting each other behind the screen and everything, so everyone's really friendly towards you. Enjoy making films, it's just so fun. I think it turned out really good because everyone was basically brilliant in it.
I heard about it in one of the peppercorns rehearsals, and some of my friends had done it, and I thought it sounded fun, so I thought I'd give it a go. I read one of the poems out of the Please Mrs. Butler books and in the audition, and it went quite well, so I was looking forward to the next one, if I got in. In my second audition, we read a part of the script in front of Darren and Steve, and you sort of saw like who else you were sort of like up against for that part. I knew that I'd been given the part of a blind girl, and I didn't know anyone who was blind, so I didn't know really how to act blind, so that was quite difficult, and I didn't know what to expect. It wasn't too hard because I didn't have too many lines. My mum and dad helped me at home and things, so it wasn't too difficult. I was a little bit nervous, but I was also really excited, and so the excitement outweighed the nervousness, so it wasn't too bad. It was quite tiring because as the week got on, you got a little bit more tired and things were getting a bit more annoying when people got their lines wrong and stuff, but it wasn't too bad. It took about a week to film, but we did a couple of weekends running up to it and a couple afterwards, sort of fitting the extra bits that we hadn't managed. I think it'll turn out really good because it's quite a funny film. It's a bit sad in some places. I think other people will like it because it's funny and, you know, sort of there's adult humour and child humour in it. I hope it'll turn out good because, you know, everybody put a lot of effort into it.
I was surprised because, I mean, I thought there'd be so many people that were auditioning, they probably would be really good, so I was quite surprised when I found out that I got a part. We were given the scripts and we had to go through the scripts and learn our lines, and then we visited Steve's house and we went through some run-throughs through the script with everybody. I wasn't really I was a bit nervous, but it was sort of overcome by excitement really, because I was so excited about doing the film, and it was really fun. I didn't really know what to expect because I'd been in Vixen before and I thought that took quite a long time to film, so I wasn't really sure, to be honest. I think it will turn out really well. I hope it turns out well. I'm not sure how I'm going to feel seeing my face on screen, but hopefully it will turn out well, yeah. I think I have learned something from it because I think it will be a really good experience, and I hope to go into like acting when I'm older in the future. So I think it will definitely give me an insight into how the filming business works. I think we were giving enough direction, yeah. It definitely helped us to perform to our best, I definitely think that, yeah. It was quite difficult because, I mean, it was a lot different from today, so you had to like change what sort of things you said. Obviously you had to say things that were in that period of time. And also the dress was very different. It was really, really fun, yeah. It was really funny. We worked really hard, but it was a really, really good experience.
We had to do an audition, like read from a book or a poem. It was a little bit hard, but I got to read straight from the book. Steve put us all together, like the boys, three of us boys, and tried out to find out who was good for the part. When I was given the part, I didn't think that I'd be able to learn the script, and I thought I'd get it all wrong on the actual day. At first, I found the lines a problem to learn, but after about 2 weeks, they were easy and I started to know them off by heart. For me, the best bits of making it would have to be the cast, because we all got on really great. The worst bits would probably be the weather, because when we did it in the summer, it was really hot, but we had to do another shot in the winter, and it was really cold. I think it'll turn out really good. I think it'll be really great.
Well, the first audition, I read a poem, and then had to read two pieces of script. And in the second audition, I read a piece of script with other people. We went round Steve's house like once a week and did rehearsals, ran through the script and things. For the first few weeks, we just had to all read through the script, and then eventually we had to do it without the script and start moving around. I learnt them by running through them at rehearsals, but also I did quite a bit at home, and I went round Lorna's house and we read through them together. First of all, when we had to do it without the script, I thought it was a bit hard. On a typical day when we arrive on set, we usually first of all have to go and get changed while the cameras and things are being set up. Then we start filming from different angles and we do it over and over again till we get it right. I did find it tiring filming all week, but it was really fun, so it didn't matter. I think the film will be quite funny and people will enjoy it. It's got a good storyline. The best bits of making the film were going up to Norfolk and filming on the railway all day. And also, I liked filming at the bed and breakfast, and that was really good. The worst bit was Actually, one point when we were at the station, when I started laughing and I just couldn't stop and we couldn't get it done and it took absolutely ages. I really, really enjoyed making it. Really fun.
The audition made me a tiny bit nervous, but it wasn't hard, I don't think. We had to go over scenes and get the expression right on our face, in our words, until Steve or Dan was happy with what I was doing. When we wake up, we have to go to the place that we're filming at and do all the scenes until Dan and Steve are both happy with what we've done. The best bits about making the film was that we got to go down to Norfolk and see all that trains and all the steam trains and go on the trains filming on there, and the cow scene, that was quite fun. The worst bits about making it was probably my mum always nagging, saying go practice your lines when I've already done it like 10 times. I thought the costumes was okay, but I didn't like the hairdo.
Summer Brook Farm project started at the end of our last production, which was Vixen. Steve and I both decided that we were interested in doing another film together, and we came up with the idea of doing a war film. And eventually, after bouncing some ideas around, Steve came up with the idea of Summer Brook Farm. After the script is written, both Steve and I go on a location hunt. For Summer Brook Farm, we obviously needed a farm, and we managed to find that at a local B&B in Abbotsley. The second location was the railway, and North Norfolk Railway were very pleased to help us out. They gave us the platform for a day and they gave us a railway carriage for the day, which was very kind of them. And the third main location really was an empty room, which we managed to dress, and we used one of the cast's homes for that. So the locations worked out really, really well. Over 2 weeks, we auditioned over 40 children for seven parts. And the way we did this was we got the children to either memorise or read a passage from a book. But the thing, the one big thing that concerned me was the big station scene in Norfolk. I've never tackled anything on the scale of that, with lots of extras and the public watching. So that was kind of a bit of an experience for me. Did have one major problem, and that was when we was coming to film the very end scene with the classic car. The bed and breakfast that we were using had some visitors, and they'd gone out for the day and they'd left their big Ford Granada right in the middle of the car park, and we needed it moving, and they'd taken their keys with them. So that was a bit of a problem trying to move the car, but in the end we managed to move it and filming took place. It was a little bit behind schedule, and I'm really pleased with the way that turned out. Our biggest problem overall, I guess, was foot and mouth disease. We started to write Summer Brook Farm in February. We cast it and got everything by April, and we had a cow scene in it. And by the end of April, foot and mouth disease had started to take hold, and we were very, very concerned that we wouldn't get anywhere near a farm at all to film the cow scene, or even the bed and breakfast place on the farm. But as it happens, that wasn't too much of a problem. The cow scene was. Nobody would let us near a farm at all. And we ended up filming the cow scene in November, which was a stark contrast to the 30 degrees that we've been working to in the summer. The cast and crew were fine. I think tempers got a little frayed during some of the filming because of the heat. But I think we're still all friends at the end of it. I really had fun making it.
The sky meets the sea.
I'm just about hanging up. I never thought I could detest children as much as I hate this bunch of gutter snipes. Get out of it.
What if?
Oh God.
Oh. Good to see you like that tonight, Lily. I think she had 2 days to catch up on.
Ollie couldn't believe it when you finished your last few cupcakes.
I think she had 2 days to catch up on. Ollie couldn't believe it. Why don't you just get through that line, woman?
Never seen a real cow before. It's a little big.
Nice. Can't you see for yourself? They are, forgive me, working class children.
Hello, Sir Gerald. And I want to treat you, Lady Fraser, with the walking back
again.
To be honest, I really don't know what to believe anymore, except that I'm confused, fed up, and miserable.
Hello, Sir Gerald. And an honour to meet you, Lady Fraser. And your beautiful daughter.
Blimey! Imagine that! 4 willies! I wonder which one to play with first.
You're 2 hands. That counts for
4 willies. I wonder which one to play with first.
We got 2 hands. Sorry.
We've got 4
hands. No, dear, on this issue.
Shut
up! Now, believe me, Victoria, this is a chance to build character. Bethany Clare must listen.
Listen.
Oh. Bethany! Beth! I know.
Well, what do they say?
Sorry, Darren.
My father used to. But well, it's his job, you see. He doesn't really get the crap. Are you Muffin?
Slipped out of my hand. I'm giving up for the Home Office to concentrate on family business. I'm coming home, Beth, to you and Emily.
What?
Emily?
Children, that's some terrible news. The worst. I'm afraid Mrs. McDougal's hatched and pulled in the bits.
Oh, Brad, do